Hey, good morning. I'm meteorologist Andrew Shipley. We're breaking in here. We do have what we call a flash flood emergency now for portions of Mission, where they've received 5 to 8 inches of rain. And we're reporting or seeing numerous reports of water rescues in and around Mission here. Now, the heaviest of that rain has now continued to push off to the west, but it still sat there for so long. And that's what we started to see, that rain piling up. And you can look just to the east over McAllen, another heavy band, and we've actually seen portions of Highway 83 close there because of water on the roadway. As this continues to pile up, that water's got to go somewhere. So we're going to zoom in here. Jim's going to zoom in here for me, and you can see, again, a lot of the heavier rain pushed off, but that right in town is where that flash flood emergency, where numerous, again, rescues have been reported by law enforcement to the National Weather Service. We're relaying that here for you. But Jim, can we zoom out here for you? Still looking at heavy rains, not only just in the Mission area, you're looking closer towards Edinburgh, McAllen, and then look at this heavy band pushing northward out towards Weslaco, and that we're going to continue to see that's all pushing northward as that circulation all around Hanna continues to bring heavy rain bands across the area. And it's not just the Mission area that's seeing the heavy flooding. We've seen flash flood watches all across the region, flash flood advisories and warnings continuing at this time as well. For you, there is the map, and you can see anywhere in the, if, Jim, if you can go back there where you were, but you're looking at still that heavy rains pushing northward. Now, even along the coastline for us, we're still seeing those heavy rains. You see anywhere in those green boxes, that's where those flash flood warnings and watches are. Now, anywhere in the red is where those tornado watches have been. We've seen a couple spin-ups just a short time ago in Cameron, Willacy County, and we've actually had some reports of possible damage down towards Brownsville International. Now, going back to the flood watches and warnings, anywhere in the darker green, that's the flash flood watch. Anywhere in those lime green boxes is where those flash flood warnings are. And again, we are watching Mission in particular, where we just had reports of people getting rescued from their vehicles because of the high water in and around that area. And again, many roads in Mission are seeing rain-covered, water-covered roadways. And it's not even just there. We're seeing in other spots, again, across the area as well. So if you can, I would stay home to this morning until things die down. We are starting to see that as the storm continues to push off to the west later on today. But the storm has weakened some. Right now, it's 60 miles an hour. Now, here's the look at the look at the rainfall, though. This is through the end of the day into tomorrow morning. Looking at 10 to 15 inches anywhere in the lower to mid-valley. And then you get mid-valley up to the upper valley, anywhere 6 to 8 inches out towards Rio Grande City. And now, this is what just the estimates are. We've already seen some spots close to already 14, 15 inches in the lower valley in spots of Cameron County. There it is, 13 and a half inches around that one mark. Anywhere really in the purple has seen 6+ inches worth of rainfall, and you kind of almost can make out where those heavy bands have sit. You get the one band through just west of Weslaco there, another band out towards Star. Towards McAllen Mission. This is actually in Hidalgo County where that the flash flood emergency is. So you can really see that water, that rain band really kind of hugged that area, and that's why again we are seeing that concern across the area. So again, if you really don't need to be on the roads this morning, stay home. That's going to be the best advice for you. Let the storm pass. But we're still looking at a lot of rain, a lot of wind still associated with Hurricane Hanna. Again, continues to push off to the west-southwest at 9 miles. So it's not moving all that fast, but it is going to start to move on off to the west there, start to weaken as well. Looking at about 40-mile-an-hour winds down from 60 right now by 1 o'clock as it pushes into the mountains and into Mexico and continues to weaken as you get in towards tomorrow as well. So we are going to continue to keep you updated on Tropical Storm Hanna as it continues to make impact here. We're also going to be looking at some more of these heavy rain bands continuing to push northward. Look at this, right up on the coastline, South Padre Island, Port Isabel, seeing those heavy bands. And this is the kind of rain that you're going to be watching for the possibility for that continued flooding across the area. That training so continues to go over the same spot over and over again and just dumping inches worth of rain. And that's what causes a lot of that flooding across the entire region. Again, this is a very broad system continuing to bring that rainfall across the area. And, you know, while you may get on one of those one band or two bands that, you know, kind of get a little bit quieter, then it picks back up as that next band inches closer towards it. But again, continuing to watch right around the Mission McAllen area. Again, heavy flooding around that area. Again, we are reporting water rescues, flash flood emergency in and around that area. And we're going to continue to keep you updated on that as we get closer to the next bottom of the half hour.